These three easy side hustles have the ability to replace your full-time job in 2022. That's coming right up. What's up, everybody? This is Adrian Brambilla, and it was about 11 years ago that I launched my very first online side hustle. I didn't know it at the time, but it would change my life. My first business was actually teaching people how to dance the robot, and it did not make much money. Actually, no one watched at the beginning. It was just my mom. Thanks, Mom, by the way. But eventually it started growing, people started watching, and then I finally launched my very first product, which was a 60-minute video, $25, teaching you how to dance, everything about waving and head isolations, and it made $1,000. Ever since then, I've been on the hunt, the chase of how could I actually make more money online in a really cool way that doesn't feel sketchy or weird or grimy, because when you ever go to Google and you try and search how to make money online, you see a pretty dark array of things that seem shady or some crypto scam or Ponzi scheme. That's not what this is about. There's actually a lot of amazing ways to make money that are ethical, that feel good. And I want to show you today three of my favorites. The first amazing easy side hustle that you could literally get started today right after watching this video is on a marketplace platform called Fiverr. And hold up. If you've heard of Fiverr before, you might be wondering or thinking there's no way that I can make a full-time living from Fiverr. When I asked my friend Alex Fazula, who is a full-time income earner on Fiverr, I said, how much do you make? How much money have you made? And she's like, over $1 million. So this marketplace got really popular, Fiverr, for basically having these listings of creating $5 orders, right? I don't want to work for $5. I don't want you to work for $5. And what I learned through her and through other content creators on Fiverr is that $5 is just the entry point. So I kind of get people to get interested in your idea of what you're offering, but you can offer something as high as $100 or even thousands of dollars. So when I learned about this, I did it for myself just to test it, and I made $1,000 in my very first month. And now I've actually been helping people make money online, and it's insane some of the testimonials that we have of people that are doing Fiverr and finding success. Don't believe me? Let me show you. So over here, this is what happens when you go on the main homepage of Fiverr. It's a marketplace and typically it's geared for buyers. If I wanted to buy pretty much anything on a service level, then Fiverr is the place and I can get it for cheap. And that's typically what deters people from actually wanting to be a seller, right? You don't want to sell things for $5, but I'm just gonna show you right now how there's so much more than $5 services, and you can get into a wider range of things. So just by clicking on the browse category, so for any of my graphic design people out there, digital marketing, if you can write or if you know a couple languages, translation, there's video animation, programming, data, business, lifestyle, it's amazing. But there's some actually fun ones. I'm gonna click on lifestyle here. And there's actually gigs for all kinds of, now we're getting to the weird part of ways to make money that's kind of cool. For example, gaming. How do you make money from gaming? Interesting. Life coaching, astrology, and psychics. Actually, I'm intrigued. Let's click on that. So let's say if you were someone with spiritual gifted powers, you would want to create a gig on here and how much money you can make. So let's see. I'm just going to look at this first one here. This is not pre-planned. Someone will create a lifetime energy assistant with the selected abilities. Okay, interesting. Now, I'm not usually a believer of this stuff, but that doesn't matter. When you are online, people of all over the world will pay you for all kinds of stuff. This person has 277 reviews, and she's not selling it for $5. Her little gig, $45 a pop. So that's just right away proof that it doesn't have to be about a $5 order. But let me do something here. I'm gonna click on this person who is a $5 order, and their gig is, I will do a full tarot reading for you within 24 hours, okay? Pretty cool. She has 1,722 reviews. That doesn't even mean orders. 5 stars, and how Fiverr works, the $5 is really just to reel you in, so that's a standard reading, but it's about kind of creating upsells, different packages. So if you click on the standard here, she has a $15 for the same service, just at a faster pace, and a premium to basically get photos as well. So when I'm teaching my Fiverr strategies and work, I actually don't mind listing something for $5, because in the like fundamental rule of creating an online business, it's about longevity and repeat business. So if I can get paid $5 for a customer at the beginning, And even though maybe at my first work with them is not worth it, I'm more thinking about the long term. So I'm gonna draw a little graph for you. This is actually like fundamental for internet business. A lot of people don't realize the importance of this simple graph that I'm about to draw. It's a ladder. And so right now, if you were to create your very first online side hustle on Fiverr and you had something for $5, you might not be too excited because $5 is not a lot of money. However, if you're long-term oriented and thinking, that $5, if you continue to add value to that person, whether it's tarot card reading, or in my case, doing social media or posting, you'll build a customer relationship. And if you are good at what you do, and you are a nice person, and you build a relationship with that $5 order, that customer may come back to you and say, what else do you have to offer? Or can I hire you to do a custom plan, and maybe you charge $100 for that? Or maybe they like you so much that they wanna offer you a job or on a retainer, and now you're making $1K a month. So although $5 is the entry point, don't be so stuck on immediate gratification about $5 and how that's not worth your time. Because if you're long-term thinking, every person that orders from you for $5 has the potential to a lot more. So think in terms with the value ladder, and then honestly, go on Fiverr and look at all the different opportunities, all the different gigs that are there, and see what you can make. Copy someone who's already doing it and see if you can make it different or unique to yourself or even make it better. Well, that's Fiverr. Pretty amazing, right? Let's talk about the next one. Side hustle number two that you should start in 2022 is teaching online. Now, you don't have to be accredited to actually teach online. It's amazing. If you are good at something, not even the best, but just good enough and you can help others, this is a side hustle for you. This website that I have open is called Skillshare. It's amazing because you can teach on it for free. Skillshare already has millions of students, customers paying, and how you make money is by the watch time on your courses. Kind of like how YouTube AdSense works, except for YouTube AdSense, first, you gotta have at least 1,000 subscribers and you need people to have a certain amount of watch time on your channel before you get monetized. On Skillshare, you could start making money today. So I'm gonna actually show you my Skillshare class because I did something pretty interesting. I uploaded my very old dance videos like from 12 years ago on the Skillshare platform. Maybe it was like over a year ago. And even though I made those videos a long time ago and it's a much younger Adrian, they make money. So I'm gonna pop on over to my backend dashboard and you can see here, total money made on Skillshare, $5,081. I have 3,438 students here and basically over 91,000 minutes watched. That equated to YouTube AdSense would be way less than basically making $5,000 from that, right? That's insane. And then I'll show you basically the last 30 days making money and what my payments look like. So even though I literally have not uploaded here in like over a year, I'm still getting money from the videos that are on here. So this is November 2021, $274. October, $203. September, $224, right? This isn't a lot of money because I'm like kind of just half-assing this, but if I had basically uploaded one video a week, I believe this could be a full-time income. Think of it. If I just added one extra zero and that $274 was now $2,744, that's a game changer. I would love to have that. And actually one of my goals for 2022 is to actually practice what I preach and start taking this seriously and uploading on here because this is going to pay me way more than YouTube per CPM, which is how much money you make every 1,000 views that you get. So as far as what you can teach, so I'm going to go back to the main dashboard here. Just like Fiverr, where there's like all kinds of ranges, my old dance videos are here. So if you are a dancer, you could definitely do that. If you are anything with marketing, of course, that's always going to be probably the go-to. But if you are good at writing and you can teach music even, or web development, it's crazy. So I'm also going to click on the lifestyle side because I always think that's where the fun out-of-the-box ideas exist. And so let's just take a look at some really cool ideas that have where people are making money. So here's one, Spanish for beginners. So someone's teaching Spanish, 26,000 students. This person's weighed way more than I have. Let's see what else looks interesting. Art from your heart, how to art journal for wellness and balance. That sounds like a very nice course, right? I just want to give you context and examples that like the sky's the limit. Like when you think about something you're good at, if you like basically played soccer in college, or if you like love like meditating, like you can actually make an impact in people's lives and teach what you know. You do not have to be an accredited teacher unless you're teaching something that like actually you really do. Like you probably shouldn't teach online. There's definitely certain things, like probably like open heart surgery, probably not the best thing to teach, even if you are world renowned. This isn't the platform. But let's take a look. Like this is random, but cool. Layer cake from scratch. Ultimate beginner's guide to cake decorating. Sweet. What if you like baking? Turn what you know into a class. I'll let you know right now if this is going to be the side hustle you're going to try. The problem you're going to discover has nothing to do with how to do this, because it's so stupid easy. The problem happens right here in the mind, because we develop this thing called imposter syndrome. You see, you start seeing who else is teaching. You say, oh my gosh, they seem so much better than I am, and I don't know if I should even be teaching. And you basically go into all this doubt about you putting yourself out there. But the truth is, you don't need to be the best. You don't need to be the best on Fiverr. You don't need to be the best on Skillshare. You just need to be relatable. You don't want to be the world's most renowned person in cake decorating to make a course. You don't need to be. But you need to be passionate, enjoy what you do, and teach other people. And whatever your background or personalities are, that's going to resonate with a good core of people. Some people hate me. It's true. And then some people like that I'm goofy and nerdy and that I lived in a van because they're also minimalist. They love that. And then some people are like, you lived in a van, you're an idiot. Like, it's just your background experience relates to some people, and then some people it turns people off. But that's the whole thing. Just be relatable. Don't try to be the best. But Skillshare, an amazing platform. If you were to combine basically creating gigs on Fiverr and Skillshare, no doubt that could be a full-time income. But there's one more side hustle you could do on top of that. This last side hustle, I'll just warn you right now, it's not going to feel as sexy and cool as passive income as maybe others too can. But if you are looking to basically quit your 9-to-5 and there's only one thing I could tell you to do, this would be it. It's actually turning your skill sets into a service. Businesses and people and influencers need your help every single day. I need a lot of help. And I pay for that help. I outsource a lot of the work that I just don't have time to do anymore. And that work, some of it is specialized, like I have someone who helps me run my ads. And then some of that work is more of like helping me manage my email, because I get thousands of emails a day and that they're basically just doing general assistance. So whether you are skilled in something and do have a background in accounting or marketing or social media, you can turn that into a service, start working for clients. Or maybe you're listening to this and like, that sounds great for people who already know how to do videography or graphic design, but I don't know anything. What you can offer is your time and help, and helping someone else be more efficient by basically being a general virtual assistant. And the place where you can find literally thousands of opportunities to apply as a job, and it's completely free to sign up, is a website called Upwork. So what's really cool about Upwork is it's a place, it's basically a huge marketplace, like a job forum, but instead of going to the office and clocking in 9-to-5, you basically can work for people and businesses all around the world and offer your services and basically get contracted for either projects or retainers. I often point people here, and some of the testimonials that I have landed six-figure contracts from an initial Upwork gig, which is absolutely amazing. So I'm just on the homepage, and I'm just gonna run through a couple ideas. So literally, if you know how to do the books for people, like finance and accounting, there's a lot of small businesses who post that need help, tax time or organizing or how to keep balance the balance sheet, like all different types of things you could do. Admin, customer support. That's like, I feel like that's where, if you're like really young watching this video and you're like in high school, actually the person, my assistant, her name is April. She's 18 years old and she's amazing. And she helps me with everything and she's learned so much. One of the best ways, if you're someone who like doesn't have a lot of experience yet, just be a virtual assistant. Say, I will do anything for you. I will just work for you. And through that process, you may not get paid a lot of money per hour, but you get to learn and basically dive into their business and start learning all different aspects. So April, when I first started and working with her, she was brand new, super green. But now she's like diversified in knowledge. She's learned from me basically like how I run my ads, the types of affiliate marketing businesses that I promote, and then how to blog, how to optimize SEO and YouTube videos and TikTok. And now she has all that knowledge and I paid her for that. Like No, people message me all the time, Adrian, can you be my mentor? I'm like, I do not have time to be a mentor for free. But basically being a virtual assistant for someone is a way to kind of get through as a mentorship program and get paid. So sometimes, depending on what stage of life you're at, it's not all about the money. It's about the intrinsic value of what you're getting in return. So I point people right away, if you're someone that has zero experience, just go to Upwork, create a nice profile, kind of like a resume, and then go and click on the admin and customer support section. There are literally thousands and thousands of jobs that you could apply for. And if you like basically this new era of modern internet businesses of influencers, look for influencers. Influencers post gigs all the time, big influencers on stuff they need help with, and you can apply, do their work, and learn at the same time. It's amazing. But let's say you are someone who does have some serious chops and skills, accounting, or writing, or translation, or design. You can get paid $100 an hour plus this website. And I have, again, so many testimonials people have sent me. I'll show them to you right now. It's people like this who are living examples that this still works today, where you can basically get paid a lot of money for already what you know. Regan started posting gigs on Upwork and now landed a six-figure contract. This is something she posted in my group. Amazing. So those are three amazing, easy side hustles that you could literally get started today if your goal was to basically call your boss up and say, hey, I'm done, I quit, so you can become a full-time entrepreneur. But let me just give a couple pieces of advice because I've been a full-time entrepreneur for 6 years. It hasn't all been romantic. And I want to let you know one thing that I did that basically made it the transition pretty easy for when I left my stable 9-to-5. I waited until my online side hustle income matched my full-time salary, which was like around $50,000 a year. I know some entrepreneurs and even close friends who were so excited and they believed in themselves so much, and it's important, you should believe in yourself, but they quit really early. And before they had much cash flow or any cash flow, and when you don't have any cash coming in, your bills start to add up, you basically start taking loans out, and all of a sudden this excitement that you had to be an entrepreneur turns into something, one of the most stressful situations of your life. So please don't do that. Like, these side hustles don't require a lot of time. An hour a day for 30 days could yield massive results. And the order I would do things is basically start on Fiverr, create a few gigs, and put your feelers out there. Then once those gigs were taken care of, start thinking about how you can start making a class every single week on Skillshare. And then lastly, for the kicker, for the big stable income, start landing gigs on Upwork. The combination of those three, who knows? Maybe like in the next couple months, you could quit your 9-to-5. And that, I'm not even saying that, like there's people who've done this that I've taught, and I have those testimonials of people who basically have done all three and do really well. And you shouldn't just do one, you should do all three. Seriously, if you are wanting to be a full-time entrepreneur at the beginning, you can't be picky. You only get to be picky once you have cash flow. Then you can decide, I don't wanna do Fiverr, that's lame, I wanna just do this. But at the beginning, you gotta do them all. In my opinion, these are the easiest, best side hustles that you can do in 2022. If you like this video, please let me know. Comment any questions you have on any one of these side hustles or anything else that I can help you out with. Otherwise, I want to say thank you so much for watching. This is Adrian. Peace and God bless.